वेलकम डियर फ्रेंड इन स्टडी बडी चैनल। माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर के एस बैंकर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन गवर्नमेंट इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज मोडासा। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ ट्रिपल टी डायग्राम। ट्रिपल टी स्टैंड फॉर टाइम, टेम्परेचर एंड ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। टाइम, टेम्परेचर एंड ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन डायग्राम, दैट इज नॉन एज TTT डायग्राम। सो today we will see about recall of the previous lectures, why TTT diagram is used, then limitation of ion carbon diagram, definition of TTT diagram, requirement of TTT diagram, and what are the steps through which we can construct a TTT diagram. Now in the previous lectures we had discussed about the ion carbon phase diagram, in which we can study about these three invariant reactions. First reaction is over here, that is paratactic reaction at the 1495 degree centigrade. Second reaction was eutectic reaction over here, and the third reaction was the eutectoid reactions at the 723 degree centigrade. Now I want zoom this portion. So in this portion you will get this gamma austenite will transform into alpha plus Fe3C, that is cementite. So I will just zoom this portion, and then we'll see about this how the austenite will transform into perlite. Okay, but before that, in the previous lecture we had also seen the paratactic reaction that occurs at 1495 degree centigrade, and the in that equation liquid plus delta converts into gamma, that is austenite. The another equation was the eutectic reaction, and that eutectic reaction occurs at 1148 degree centigrade, and in eutectic reactions liquid transformed into gamma plus Fe3C, and this mixture of gamma plus Fe3C is known as ledeburite. And third reaction was eutectoid reaction, occurs at 723 degree centigrade, in which gamma austenite transform into alpha ferrite plus cementite, that is Fe3C, and this mixture of alpha ferrite and cementite is known as perlite. Now we have discussed this ion carbon diagram in the previous lectures, and there is three reactions: paratactic, eutectic and eutectoid. Now the limitation of ion carbon diagram is over here. Okay, in all these reactions, because ion carbon diagram just shows the transformation at the equilibrium phase. This is the equilibrium phase, here is equilibrium phase, and here is equilibrium phase. So ion carbon diagram shows only the transformation at the equilibrium phase only, equilibrium conditions. And if the transformations done at the far away from the equilibrium positions, then this ion carbon diagram is unable to show that transformation. So to understand this, which type of transformation, we did not get the information from this phase diagram, that's why we will just zoom these portions and understand. Okay, now this is the small portion of the ion carbon diagram. I have zoomed it to understand the perlite transformation. So here what happened, in this region austenite is there. So during cooling, when it reach at this point, that is eutectoid point, so at the 723 degree centigrade, this isotherm austenite transform into alpha plus Fe3C. Okay, this austenite converts into alpha plus Fe3C, this one, and this is known as perlite. But here what happens, this austenite will reach over here and it will not immediately transform at the 723 degree centigrade. It will take some time to transform from austenite to perlite. But in this iron carbon diagram, we did not get the information how much time is required to transform this gamma into perlite. Here we will just predict that, or we will just know that the perlite is formed, but after how much time it will produce or how much time is taken to transform the gamma into perlite. So this information we will not get from this iron carbon diagram. So this is the limitation of iron carbon diagram, and to overcome these limitations we have to study about the triple T diagram. Okay, so the question arises, why TTT diagram is there? So due to overcome the limitation of iron carbon diagram, we have to study about the triple T diagram. So first is, iron carbon diagram is not telling us how much time the transformation will take place. So we need to know what is the time spent for a transformation. Okay, and this information cannot be provided by iron carbon diagram. Then how long we have to wait, this is the answer which comes from the time, temperature and transformation, that is TTT diagram. Okay, so triple T diagram will give you the answer how long we have to wait to get this perlite transformation from the austenite. Okay, so here time, temperature and transformation, that is TTT diagram, is also known as S curve, C curve, Benz curve or isothermal transformation diagram. Now here new word comes arrive, isothermal. So what is isothermal? So isothermal transformation means the transformation allowed or occurs at a constant temperature, and that reaction or that diagram is known as isothermal transformation diagram. Okay, means the transformation occurs at constant temperature. Now the iron carbon equilibrium diagram shows only the phases and the resulting microstructure corresponding to only the equilibrium conditions. So we will get the transformation at the equilibrium condition only. Okay, suppose equilibrium conditions at 1495 degree centigrade. So we will get the peritactic reactions at the another equilibrium conditions 1148 degree centigrade. At that equilibrium conditions we will get the eutectic reactions, and another eutectic condition is 723 degree centigrade. So this iron carbon diagram will give us the transformation shows at the equilibrium conditions only. That's why we have to study about the TTD diagram. We have to also know about the cooling rate. So as the cooling rate increases, the experimentally observed transformation temperature are lowered and metastable phases may be formed. Okay, so it depends on the cooling rate also. So here in iron carbon diagram also we'll not get the information about how much cooling rate is there. This is also one limitations. Now see here, for example, at very high rate of cooling, if cooling rate is very high in the steel, a metastable phase called martensite can develop, and which cannot be found in the iron carbon diagram. The principal source of information on the actual process of austenite decompositions under non-equilibrium conditions is the TTT diagram. So we will not get the austenite decompositions under non-equilibrium condition in iron carbon diagram. That's why if we know about the austenite decompositions at the non-equilibrium condition, then we must have to study about the triple T diagram, which relates the transformation of austenite to the time and temperature. Got it? Now, how can you draw the triple T diagram? So here the steps are there, some steps to construct the triple T diagram. Step number one, obtain a large number of relatively small specimen. Okay, so first step is you have to cut the very small specimen from a large bar for your experimental purpose. Step number two, place the samples or specimen in a molten bath. This is the molten bath. So place the specimen in a molten salt bath held at the proper austenitizing temperature. The temperature of this molten bath is austenitizing temperature, means it is the temperature above 723 degrees centigrade, because at the 723 degrees centigrade, above that temperature, your perlite will transform into austenite. That's why place your sample or specimen in a molten bath with a proper temperature of austenitizing temperature. And for eutectoid steel, this temperature is approximately 774 degree centigrade, and in Fahrenheit it is the 1425 degree centigrade. So the temperature of this molten bath is around or approximately 774 degree centigrade. So first step is cut the small specimen from a long bar. Suppose this is a long bar, then cut the small specimen and held that individual specimen in the molten bath. Now step number three, when austenitized, the samples are quickly transferred. Okay, suppose this is your sample and the sample is austenitized, means your sample is converted into austenite, then this specimen is transferred into the cold water for a certain time. So this is called quenching. This process is called quenching. When austenitized, the samples are quickly transferred to another molten salt bath held at the desired reaction temperature, and that is temperature below lower critical temperature, that is A1. Okay, so lower critical temperature is 723 degree centigrade, and below the lower critical point, that is 705 degree centigrade. So you have to maintain the temperature of this bath is 705 degree centigrade. Then step number four, after given specimen has been allowed to react isothermally for a certain time, it is quenched in a cold water. Okay, so after we held this specimen in a austenitized molten bath, then we transferred into the cold water, and that process is called quenching. Okay, now the first specimen may be allowed to react isothermally for 2 seconds. After 2 seconds, we have to just check it, how much perlite is formed. Now for the second specimen, you just place it for the 4 seconds, then check it, the microstructure, how much perlite is formed. Then for third specimen, allowed for 15 seconds, then again check the microstructure. Okay, so allow the different specimen for the different time and just check the microstructure of this, then it depicts in some graph. The more, now what you will observe by this experiment, the more time is given to a specimen to react isothermally, the more perlite is formed. Okay, so if you held a specimen in a quench or in a water, then more perlite will formed. If time is more, then perlite will formed, more perlite will form. Now see this figure, in which suppose this is the specimen 1. So you allow this specimen in a cold water for 4 seconds. So small perlite is formed. This black portion is called perlite, okay, and this white portion is called austenite. So this small austenite will transport into perlite. If you allow that specimen in the cold water for 4 seconds, then this is the another specimen which allowed in a cold water for suppose 30 minutes. Then here the another the more percentage of perlite will form. Then if you allow it for more minute or 1 hour, then more perlite will form. Then if you allow this specimen in cold water for the hours, 2 or 3 hours, up to 3 hours, then it will, more perlite will form. Means you can just predict that time, if you allow the specimen for the longer time, then more perlite will form. Okay, so from this diagram you just mark the different experiment, and then finally if you join this point, then you will get the S curve. That's why this triple T diagram known as C curve or S curve. So this is the reaction curve found by metallographic examination of processed specimen. So ultimately what you observed, more time is given or at the very fast cooling, or once you place your austenitized sample into cold water bar, then if time is more, if you allow or if you held it the specimen for the more time, then more perlite will form. Okay, so this can be seen in the triple T diagram only, and this cannot be seen in the iron carbon diagram at any time. Okay, so this is the triple T diagram. Okay, so in the next lecture we will more discuss about the triple T diagram. Up till now just refer this lecture, just see this lecture more and more time, so it will clear the idea how, why the triple T diagram is required and how you just draw the triple T diagram. Okay, this is just introduction of triple T diagram. In next lecture we will give you the more information about triple T diagram. Up till now, thank you very much. Have a nice day. Thank you.